Thank you very much. Good evening, President Walker and the rest of the board members. I'm Ian Mazzochi, the state representative for part of the school district in this area. 2 days ago, Governor Pritzker told reporters that he supports locally elected officials making decisions to ensure the health and safety of their members. Today, he issued an executive order, we're now in the high 80s, to take that away from students, parents, teachers, and school boards. I'm here tonight to warn you that you cannot count on the majority party in its in the legislature in Springfield to protect you from executive overreach. Frankly, they don't want to. The power that Pritzker is exercising over this school by his most recent executive order is power that he tried to get through legislation. It passed the House. It didn't get through the Senate. He apparently doesn't care, but I suggest to you, you very much should. I would urge the members of this board to take every step that they can to protect your students from this invasion into your jurisdiction. The data in DuPage, and in this district in particular, do not justify the draconian actions that the governor is going to impose on you, especially when it's weighed against the real-world harm that your students have already experienced, to say nothing about the damage and the infringement to civil liberties, the invasion into personal health decisions that belong to an individual and their doctor, and even to the right of collective bargaining. It's regrettable that context has been missing from the COVID discourse that's been happening at the executive level in Springfield. But earlier tonight, one of you asked, and one of you commented on some of the things that you'd like to be able to say you stand for. I would ask you to stand for your independence, to stand up for your parents and for your students, to make sure that you are doing your own independent findings about what your students need and not blindly relying on a bureaucracy that frankly doesn't know what your local situation is like. I also would ask you to set an example for your students and to essentially try to create a culture of courage, of calm, and to not emulate the governor's culture that he's been creating, which is anxiety, disruption, and fear. I'm leaving my contact information for you. I would certainly urge all of you board members or any of your administrators, if you'd like to reach out to me further to find out what's going on in Springfield, please do. My door is always open. While we will be in Springfield for a special session on August 31st so that a political map can once again be drawn, unfortunately, we are not going to be there to protect our local schools to do the job you need to do. And I apologize to you for that. Thank you.
Thank you.